New solar-powered invention creates hydrogen fuel from the atmosphere. Researchers have created a solar-powered device that produces hydrogen fuel directly from moisture in the air. According to its inventors, the prototype produces hydrogen with greater than 99% purity and can work in air that is as dry as 4% relative humidity. The device would allow hydrogen to be produced without carbon emissions even in regions where water on land is scarce. Hydrogen is a zero-carbon fuel that yields only water as a byproduct when combusted. However, pure hydrogen is not abundant in nature, and producing it requires energy input. Large-scale production commonly involves fossil fuels that generate carbon emissions. The study's lead author and a senior lecturer in chemical engineering at the University of Melbourne, Dagergang Kevin Lay, said the hydrogen-producing device could be powered by solar or wind energy. A prototype produced hydrogen for more than 12 consecutive days in a monitored trial. For one of them, the researchers left it to run by itself for 8 months. The device is comprised of spongy material with a hygroscopic liquid, fluid that absorbs moisture from the air, similar in function to silica gel sachets. The absorbed water molecules are then split at electrodes into hydrogen and oxygen gases, a process known as electrolysis. The researchers believe that hydrogen is the ultimate clean energy as long as you have renewable sources of energy to electrolyze the water. The device is estimated to produce up to 93 liters of hydrogen a square meter an hour. If you have 10 square meters of this unit, it can power a whole house to replace your consumption of natural gas at home for cooking and heating. The prototypes are still only small in size, and the team has plans to create 1 square meter and 10 square meters units in the coming year. The researchers envisage the device could be a useful tool in regions where liquid water is not readily available for producing hydrogen. While useful, this technology likely won't be a silver bullet for reaching net zero because of the required economies of scale, which probably won't be reached with clean hydrogen right away because of the expensive price of conventional hydrogen electrolyzers. A new boost for solar cell production using copper. The rising price and low availability of raw materials, especially silver, are leading to higher costs in producing photovoltaic modules. Fraunhofer researchers have developed an electroplating process that involves substituting silver, an expensive precious metal, with copper, which is more readily available. They have also succeeded in replacing the polymers that are usually left over after electroplating processes and are expensive to dispose of, by instead using easily recyclable aluminum for masking. In order to bring the technology to the market more quickly, the spin-off PV2 Plus was launched. When it comes to generating electricity from renewable energies, photovoltaics are a mainstay. Modern heterojunction solar cells have a particularly low carbon dioxide footprint on account of the low amounts of silicon used to produce them. And when it comes to industrial production, they achieve the highest levels of efficiency. As a result, the chances are high that this technology will become the standard in production. There are figures to show the growing importance of photovoltaics. According to the International Renewable Energy Agency, more than 96 terawatt-hour of energy was produced by photovoltaic systems worldwide in 2012, which rose to nearly 831 terawatt-hour by 2020. According to the German Environment Agency, the amount of electricity generated from photovoltaics in Germany rose from almost 27 terawatt-hour to almost 50 terawatt-hour in the same period. This is by no means the limit of what photovoltaics can offer. However, when manufacturing solar cells, valuable silver is used for busbars and contacts, which conduct the electricity that is generated in the silicon layer by means of solar radiation. The cost of this precious metal is rising even today. Silver accounts for around 10% of the manufacturing price of a photovoltaic module. Moreover, there are only limited quantities of the metal available on Earth. The solar industry processes 15% of the silver mined, but due to the industry's high growth rate, this proportion is set to rise sharply. This will not be viable, however, as other sectors, such as electromobility and 5G technology, also report an expected future increase in their use of silver. That is why the solar industry requires breakthrough technological innovations to realize its full potential. To ensure that the electrically conductive surface of the solar cell is not completely electroplated with copper, the areas of the surface that should not be coated must first be masked. These areas are covered by a coating that has an electrically insulating effect, thereby preventing them from being electroplated. The copper layer will only build up in the areas not coated with the insulation. The researchers have made another significant advance here. Until now, expensive polymer-based lacquers or laminated foils have been used in this industry to mask the silicon wafer in the electrolyte bath. Properly disposing of the polymers is an expensive process that generates a lot of waste. Dr. Glatthar and his team have been able to substitute the polymers with aluminum. Just like copper, aluminum is fully recyclable. Switching the materials twice, from silver to copper and from polymer to aluminum, also brings twice the benefit. Producing solar cells is not only more sustainable, but also significantly cheaper. But how did the researchers manage to replace silver, an expensive precious metal? The researchers developed a special electroplating process that makes it possible to use copper instead of silver for the busbars. This even improves conductivity. The copper contact lines are particularly narrow on account of their laser structuring. Due to the copper line's extremely small width of only 19 micrometers, the light-absorbing silicon layer experiences less shading than with the silver lines. This and the high conductivity of electroplated copper improve the electricity yield. The Fraunhofer team has also made a second technological achievement in using aluminum as a masking layer. The difficulty here is the electrically conductive nature of aluminum, which renders it at first glance unsuitable to use as a mask. The Fraunhofer researchers took advantage of the fact that aluminum can form an insulating oxide layer on its surface. However, this layer is only a few nanometers thick. They were able to adapt the process parameters and develop a special type of electrolyte, which ensures that the aluminum's extremely thin, native oxide layer can reliably fulfill its insulating function. This was an important milestone for the success of their research project. As recyclable materials, both copper and aluminum can bring photovoltaic production much closer to the circular economy, improving environmental and social standards in the process. Given that there are sufficient supplies of copper in Germany, the supply chains are much shorter and the price is less dependent on international raw material markets or foreign suppliers. In order to bring the promising technology to the market more quickly, Fraunhofer ISE launched the spin-off PV2+. The letters P and V stand for photovoltaics, with 2+ indicating the double positive charge of copper ions in the electroplating bath. The company is also based in Freiburg, with Fraunhofer researcher Dr. Glatthar acting as CEO. He is aiming to set up a pilot production plant together with industrial partners as early as the start of 2023. As Professor Andreas Bett, Institute Director of Fraunhofer ISE, explained that these innovative solar cells are an important stepping stone on the way to a future power supply based on renewable energies. They will give the photovoltaics industry a much-needed boost. The spin-off has huge potential to quickly and successfully establish itself on the market. They are particularly pleased that these technologies were developed at their institute.